Hey guys, once again welcome back to the brand new video. In this video we will create a nice and simple product slideshow animation that is super easy to create inside of DaVinci Resolve. You can also call this animated product advertisement. This is Vikas from Skyline Motions, and without any further ado, let's create a new project and get started. Alright, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve 18 edit page, and before we get started we have to do some basic setting as usual. So click on the setting button in the corner and set the size of this project 1920 by 1080. Let's select a frame rate. So in this case I am using this 60 frame per second, which is absolutely perfect for smooth animation. And now you can click on save. Now I'm going to create this animation inside of this fusion page. So we have to take a new fusion composition. So just go to this media pool, right click on that, click on this new fusion composition. Let's call it anything. Duration make it 5 seconds long, frame rate 60, and click on create. Now just drag this fusion composition on this timeline just like that. Place the CDI on this fusion composition and then go to the fusion page. And here we have the media out node, so just drag this media out to the side for now. And for this animation we need only one viewer, so you can click on this single viewer. Let's increase the size of this flow window, and after that let's start by creating a background. So this is the background button. Let's drag and drop on this flow window and drag this background to the viewer. This is the color. Let's change the color to white. After that we need one more white background, so this is the background. Let's drag and drop, change the color to white. And this is going to be the shape layer, so we have to connect the rectangle tool with the second background. So click on this rectangle tool and let's create a rectangular shape. But before that we have to drag and drop this second background to the viewer. Now select the rectangle, go to the inspector window, and here we have the width and height. So let's increase the width value and set the value 0.9 in the width and 0.8 in the height. And let's increase the corner radius. So I'm going to set the value maybe 0.15, and then let's drag the shape right over here. And after that we have to create a drop shadow effect for the shape layer. So select the second background, hit Ctrl plus a spacebar for search box and search for drop shadow. So this is the drop shadow, hit add button, just drag this drop shadow to the viewer. After that we need to merge both the outputs. So this is the first output and this is the second output. So it's very simple to merge. So just connect the foreground output with the background output. Just drag the merge right over here and drag it to the viewer. And finally we have to do some setting with the drop shadow. So select the drop shadow, go to inspector window, and here we have the drop distance. Let's set the drop distance 0. Let's increase the blur value and set the value 0.75 maybe. And let's decrease the shadow strength and set the value maybe 0.25, and now it's looking perfect. Finally we have to change the color, so this is the black color. Let's change this to red and we will get this type of output, which is looking nice. And after that we need to create animated shapes, so it's very simple. Let's create a new background first, and this is going to be the shape layer. So select the background, add an ellipse mask with this, select the ellipse. And here we have the solid, so let's uncheck the solid. Let's increase the border width and set the border width value maybe 0.0012. all right and now you can drag and drop the background to the viewer, and you can see the thin line over here. Now let's decrease the size a little bit, so I'm going to set the value maybe 0.22 in width, 0.22 in height. After that we need to create a liquid kind of animation. So select the background 3 output, hit Ctrl plus a spacebar for search box and search for displace. So this is the displace node, hit add button. Now we need to create a noise for this displace. So this is the fast noise button. Let's drag and drop on this flow window. Let's connect the fast noise with the displace and drag this fast noise to the viewer. We need to do some setting with the fast noise, so just go to the inspector window and here we have the contrast. Let's increase the contrast value and set it 5, and let's increase the scale value a little bit. So I'm gonna set the value maybe 3, and we have to animate the seat value. So right click on seat value, click on expression. I'm going to use a time expression for this. So let's type time multiply by 0.01. All right. And we will get this type of animation, which is looking nice. After that, let's drag this displays to the viewer. And finally, select the displays and do the setting with this reflection strength. So let's increase the reflection strength and set the value maybe 0.2. After that, we need to create multiple copy of this. So select the displays, hit Ctrl plus a spacebar for search box and search for duplicate. So this is the duplicate node, hit add button, drag this duplicate to the viewer. Let's set the number of copy maybe 15. And let's set the center X value maybe 0.497. And let's increase the size a little bit. So I'm going to set the value 1.03 maybe. All right, it's perfect. Now you can click on fit button. And finally, we have to change the color. So select the background, go to the type and change this to gradient. And here we have to select a gradient color. So for this project, I'm going to use the pink color for the first color, and the second color should be the orange. And now we will get the nice color combination. And finally, we need to create two different output for this. So select the main output, add a transform node, attach one more transform, and this is going to be the second output. So connect the main output of this duplicate one with this transform two, and finally we have two different output. Now let's place it over here, and we need to merge both the output. So connect the first output with the second, and we will get the new merge. Just drag and drop to the viewer. And finally, we have to connect the main output for this one with the main background. So connect the output of this merge 2 with this merge 1, and we will get this new merge 3. Just drag and drop to the viewer. Now select the transform 1 and place the first shape over here, just like that. Select the second transform and place it over here maybe. After that, we need to create a circular shape. So it's very simple again. Let's take a new background, attach an ellipse mask with this, and place the circle right over here maybe. And finally, we have to merge it with the main background. So connect the output of this background 4 with the merge 3, and we will get the new merge, merge 4. Let's drag and drop to the viewer. Select the background and let's create a gradient color. So select the type gradient, and again select same color. Just like that. You can select any color that you like. And finally, we have to add our product over here. So just go to the media pool, right click on that, click on import media, and I'm going to use this headphone image, which is a PNG file with transparent background. You can use any transparent image. Click on open. You can download the complete project file from the link given in the description, and you will get the headphone image inside of that, so you don't have to worry about it. Now let's drag the headphone image on this flow window, hit F2, call it image. Now let's connect the image with the main output, just like that, and drag the merge 5 to the viewer. Now you can decrease the size a little bit and place the headphone over here. And after that, we need to add some text over here. So for the text, let's create a text node by dragging like this. Connect the text 1 with the merge 5, and we will get a new merge. Drag and drop to the viewer. Select the text and type the first line, great festive. Now for this one, I'm going to select the black color, and for the font, I'm using the Moderna font style, which is looking perfect for this. Let's increase the size a little bit. So I'm going to set the value 0.12, and let's set the line spacing and set the value maybe 0.6. You can place the text right over here. And after that, we need to add one more text. That is going to be the bigger text. So let's take another text node, connect the text 2 with the merge, and we will get the new merge 7. Select the text and type cell. You can type anything, whatever you want. And now select the black color, and for this one, I'm using the GoBold font style. Let's increase the size and set the value maybe 0.166 and place the second line over here maybe. Perfect. Now you can close the media pool and click on fit button. And after that we need to create a button over here. So let's take another background node, attach a rectangular mask, and let's create a button like a structure. So I'm going to set the width value maybe 0.18 and height value 0.09. Let's increase the corner radius and set it to 1.0 and place the button over here just like that. And after that we need to add a text for the button. So this is the text node. Let's connect the text with the background 5, which is the button, and drag the merge 8 to the viewer. Select the text and type the callout text just like that. And I'm gonna place the buy now text over here. Let's decrease the size and set it in the center. And now we can change the color for the button. So select the background again. Let's change this to gradient. Select the gradient color, maybe pink and the orange color. Perfect. And now let's merge this merge 8 output with the merge 7 and drag this merge 9 to the viewer. All right. And now we have to add a price tag over here. So again, we have to take a new background node and we need to connect the ellipse with the background 6, create a small circle over here and place it over here maybe. And finally, we have to add a price text. So this is the text. Let's merge the text with the background 6. And now let's drag this merge 10 to the viewer. Select the text and type the price and place the price inside of the circle just like that. And finally, let's connect the main output of this price tag with the main background and we will get the new merge. And finally, we will get this type of output. All right, now you can adjust the position of the shape. So this is the transform one. Let's place this over here maybe, just like that. And this is the second transform. You can place it over here maybe. It's looking perfect. And we have to create a gap over here. So select all the merge nodes with the main background and create a space over here just like that. And go to over here on a circle, select the background, add a transform node, and this transform is going to be the animation. So hit F2 on the keyboard to rename and call it animation. Hit OK. Now select the animation, go to on frame number 60, which is equal to 1 second. Right click on center, click on animate, go to very first frame of this animation and drag it over here maybe, maybe outside of this frame in the bottom, and set the value -1. All right, and let's drag this merge 11 to the viewer and go to on frame number 220. Right click on center, click on set key and lock the position value as it is. Go to 60 frame forward in time, maybe 1 second forward in time. So it should be frame number 280. And this time let's drag the circle outside of this frame and set the value maybe 2. All right. And this animation is linear right now, so we have to make it smoother. Just go to spline window, hit F4 on the keyboard to full screen. This is the animation. So let's check the animation, minimize it, click on fit, select both the keyframes, hit S to smooth, select these two keyframes, hit S to smooth. Set the CTI at very beginning of this animation, hold this handle, drag it like this and create a nice smooth curve. Place the CTI at the end of this animation right over here, highlight this point, hold this handle and just drag it like this. And now we have this smooth animation. Now I'm going to use the same animation node for all the layers. So Select the animation, hit Ctrl C to copy. Select the image, hit Ctrl V to paste. Select the text 1, hit Ctrl V to paste. Select the text 2, hit Ctrl V, and do the same thing. Just attach the animation node just after the main output, hit Ctrl V to paste. And now we will get this type of effect, but we have to create a time gap between each layers. So just go to spline window, hit F4 on the keyboard to full screen. Let's minimize all the layers. Click on fit button. Leave the first animation as it is. Go to 5 frame forward in time over here. Select all the keyframes and move it on frame number 5. Go to on frame number 10, maybe 5 frame forward in time. Uncheck the animation 1. Move all the keyframes over here. Go to 5 frame forward in time. Uncheck the animation 2. Move the keyframe over here. And do the same thing for all these layers. So just go to 5 frame forward in time, uncheck this animation 3, move the keyframe over here, go to 5 frame forward in time, uncheck the animation 4, and place the keyframe over here. Now we can see the difference. Alright, it's looking perfect. And now let's adjust these two layers. So I think this is the headphone layer. Select all the keyframe and move it on frame number 15. A little bit more over here. Now it is looking perfect. You can close this spline window. And now just go to over here, maybe on this output, hit Ctrl V to paste and connect the animation over here for these two shapes. So now you can see the difference. All right, and finally we have to animate this shape. So just go to the drop shadow, go to on frame number 60, which is equal to 1 second, and here we have this shadow strength. So right click on shadow strength, click on animate, go to 30 frame back in time, maybe half a second, and set the shadow strength maybe 0, and go to on frame number 220, right click on shadow strength, click on set key, go to 30 frame forward in time over here, and let's set the strength 0, and we will get this type of animation. All right, and finally we have to connect the media out with the main output, and then go to the edit page, and you can turn on the loop button, go to very first frame, hit Ctrl F to full screen, and let's have a look. Alright, so it's looking awesome, and that's all for this tutorial. I hope you guys like it. If you like it, then hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notification for more interesting videos. My name is Vikash, and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.